Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I'm hoping to do for you tonight is to let you know what you get in the box with Endangered. I am recording this unboxing video because I want to dig into this game from Grand Gamers Guild and get playing it, but I figure why not record it so you get to experience it as I do, as well as this will give you your first impressions on whether this looks like a good game for you or your group. Now, Endangered does come from Grand Gamers Guild, who I have to thank for sending us, or actually letting us take home, a review copy of Endangered from Origins. And I also have to call them out because they are the official sponsor of the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast. So thank you, Mark, for both of those. Now, this is a game about saving an endangered species. And this particular box gives you two species, one of which is going to make my co-host very happy. In this box, we are going to try to save the lions and one other species, but we'll discover that when we open it up. Now, I got to shout out right away, the Dice Tower, big fans of this game. So you know that's a good sign as it is. So step one is cutting the shrink. So we're going to have to cut the shrink on this. I'm going to tip the camera down and show you what you get in Endangered from Grand Gamers Guild. This is a cooperative game, ages 10 plus, 1 to 5 players, about an hour playtime. Again, 1 to 5, so you can play this solo. All right, here we have it. I've cut the shrink on my copy of Endangered, a game of survival by Joe Hopkins. It's a game about saving endangered species from Grand Gamers Guild. You know what? Foam in a box. Interesting. What's odd is like everything is just loose, but there's foam in one corner. Oh, it's to hold the board in place. All right. So we got a bit of a mess here. We're going to go through each of these one at a time. There's a sticker, so I don't know what the sticker's for. Something might need to be stickered. Let's go with dice. So this is a dice placement game. And the what we're looking at here are actually the dice for the players in the rather unique player colors, a purple, gray, brown, and teal, and olive. So those are your player dice. There should be 3 in each color. Part of the game is going to be rolling these and spending them to take actions. These are just standard D6 dice rounded with pips. Then we have the calendar token, which I'll take out. Why not? This is for tracking how deep into the game it is, because it is a timed game. You only have so much time to save the animals. Then we have the tiger meeples. These will represent the species on the board. No silk screen or anything, but nice, well cut. You can clearly tell that is a tiger. In orange. And then the part I didn't even know until getting this game home, the thing that's going to make my co-host very happy, you have the otters. The wooden otter meeples, because the second species you get in the base game of Endangered is you are trying to save the otters. There are some marking cubes here that are used to mark how far you progressed on various cards. These are just wooden green cubes, pretty simple, basic board game component we've all seen before. There is some extra baggies in here for organizing all of this, which, you know what, I'm going to leave them out, I think, to put these cards in. So here we have some of the cards. I'm just going to cut the shrink on this. Yes, there might be a quick release. I hate trying to open that way. I much prefer to use a hobby knife. Yes, I see the remnants of the quick release here. See, it was there. So here you have various cards. There is a card aspect to this game where you're going to put things in play to let you take more actions. Card design is nice. Iconography is very clear. My aging eyes greatly appreciate the size of that font. Yeah, that font size is really nice. I can read that from here, and that's saying a lot. This says, reveal the top card of the impact deck, then discard it or put it back on top. So we're going to quickly just flip through some of these cards. Iconography looks really clear. Yeah, I was going to say I got into different types of cards here, so let's split these. Okay, so these are the cards for each of the TV wildlife hosts is one of the characters. They're their specific cards. Then we have the philanthropist is another one of the main characters. We have their cards. So they are, that's why they're different colors. We have the lobbyists cards and the zoologist cards here. And there should be more. So I'm going to just kind of split these up over on this side until I open this pack.
Okay.
This is the second pack. Some rule summary cards. Then we have the impact cards. That's basically your bad events, bad things happening. And they are separate. So there is a deck for the sea otters. And we have all the terrible things that are happening that are ruining it, like a persistent impact. This is an oil spill. And this is a, well, it's a little hard to read. Toxoplasma gond. Now, this game, from what I understand, is intended to be somewhat educational and not fantasy-based at all. So based on actual problems that tigers are facing and otters are facing. So there are two decks, one for each. These are the laws you are trying to get put into place to help out the various species based on the number of cubes and stuff. So these are laws that you're trying to get put into place, and they're various colors representing various different countries. And then we have the rest of the wildlife host cards. Put those over there. These are the summary cards. Now there should be a little packet for each of the species. This goes through the special rules for when you are doing the tigers. It's got a nice little fold out, shows you how to set up the board and so on, as well as the ways to play, three different difficulty modes for playing with tigers. And then you have a similar thing for the sea otters with a nice little fold out kind of thing, and it shows you how to set up the board and then three levels of play. Next we have the, I think these are special abilities for the characters. So there's these two for each of the different characters that say things like, get a different angle. Anytime you roll the die during your turn, you can discard a card from your hand to reroll the dice. So these are the special abilities for the various characters. I'm going to toss those back. Still haven't found a rule book. Okay. So this may be the solo rules. Yeah, because I knew there was a fifth character. So this is the environmental lawyer deck, which was packaged separately with their own summary card. So I'm not sure why that one's separate. I'm going to keep it separate just in case it matters for something. So next we get to the game board. If I remember, this should be small enough to fit on the camera. Yeah, it's not a huge board. So what we have here is our grid that we're going to fill with various animals. You'll note there were some dice that must be somewhere around here. There's a brown and a black die that are used for figuring out coordinates. This is your calendar that shows your difficulty. And then on this is the lion side of the board. These are standard actions you can always take because you haven't put new ones in. And then the other side, of course, is the otter side of the board, which shows a shoreline and the various abilities. Very clear, concise, easy to see. There they are. I knew they had to be somewhere. These are your coordinates dice. So it's, again, two dice, one orange, one black, brown. I guess it's supposed to be brown. Standard D6 rounded corners. Lastly, if we get to the rules of play for Endangered, there should be some punch boards, I think, too. Okay. Yes. So I'm going to get to those in a second. So these are just the punch boards. So money is represented by stacks. That's your main resource in the game. These are for the characters. You're going to slot your dice in here. And then these show if you've acted or not. So you basically hold on to your token until you've gone, and then it moves up to the on top of the calendar. So lots of money, and then character boards for each of the tokens. And then these are devastation tiles. These mean the environment in that area is ruined. That's the tiger side, and then the oil slick side for the sea otters. So your devastation tiles. I knew there was cardboard in here somewhere. That was in the very bottom of the box. So we're going to quickly go through the rules. This is not a thick rule book. This is not a very complicated, heavy game. There is an introduction. So again, ages 10 plus kind of shows the components. We just went through all of those. We get to the setup here. So we're at 9 pages total, which isn't a lot for a hobby board game. So it shows you how to set up the tigers, but the rules are basically the same. How to set up your player board, which is basically pick one of your skills to use, grab your deck, grab your dice. It's not, as I said, an overly complicated in the actual gameplay. You're going to take actions by spending dice. You're then going to play cards. You can then reach out to the ambassadors to try to get laws placed, which are into place. There's an offspring rule. If you do have two mating pair together, new animals will produce. The destruction phase is when things are terrible and you start losing your habitats. And then there's an upkeep phase. Winning and losing, and then some general rules. There you have it. Everything you get in Endangered, which I'm going to keep this foam thing in here because that seems great to hold that into place. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all these cards and toss them into a Ziploc bag just so I don't lose any of them. So the rest of this is just going back into the box. But I am going to take these card decks, put them together. There we go. All back together. There you have what you get in the box with Endangered from Grand Gamers Guild, a game about saving the tigers and the otters. I find it very odd that they like, yes, there's an otter on the back. They don't really promote the fact that there's two full games in here in a way. Cooperative game, dice drafting, looks really cool. The big thing draw for this one for me is going to be my kids. I think my kids are going to love this. And I do have to say, I called it out already, but finding out there's an otter version, I have a feeling that's going to make Sean, my co-host on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, rather happy that we now have an otter-themed board game to review. So I do have to thank Grand Gamers Guild for sending us home from Origins with a copy of Endangered. Really looking forward to checking this one out. It looks good. I think my kids are really going to dig it. Seems like an interesting one. I think it's also going to be a good one for public play. And even better, it seems like the kind of game that may actually spark some discussion, which is always good to see. So thank you for joining me for this unboxing video. Again, I am Mo Tuzano of the Tabletop Bellhop. You can find me all over the internet as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. You can find me at tabletopbellhop.com. We've got a Discord if you want to head over there, chat with other fans and other gamers. That's at discord.tabletopbellhop.com. We've also got a newsletter, newsletter.tabletopbellhop.com. You seen the trend? If you search Tabletop Bellhop, you're going to find me. And probably Sean too. So thank you for joining me for this unboxing video. If you do appreciate this, you can head over to patreon.com/you know what to tip your bellhop. Good day and game on.